This is a good vibe.
Super good vibe.
Wow, such an awesome song.
So good. KT, this is my karaoke song.
Yeah, but the problem is, so I live like 15 minutes from the Cape when there's no traffic. When there is traffic, it's 3 hours.
Dude, it's all those people trying to get down there for piña coladas.
I know that. And the worst part is the dunes, you can't even go on the dunes anymore because they're all blocked off because they're like natural habitat or something.
Yeah, but back in Rupert Holmes' day, there's none of that. None of that, you know.
Oh, yeah.
You could go roll around in the dunes of the Cape any old time. Well,
that wasn't that long ago.
Not for you, maybe.
Oh, thanks.
So you're welcome. Oh.
Thanks, man. Here, let me go put my walker up. Give me a minute.
Yeah, it's good. Yeah.
I gotta go talk to my nurse and see if I can continue this conversation. My blood pressure's getting high.
Oh, okay. Actually a beautiful story.
Hang on, man. Hang on. I ran out of the lactate drink thing that I'm supposed to be drinking. So hold on. And yeah. I gotta get my kids to see and show me how to work this Zoom. Give me a minute.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, grab your children. So I waited with high hopes. What's up, Tuan? What's up, Stephanie?
And I just realized the entirety of this song right now is absolutely irrelevant because this is literally 4 text messages. The whole song.
That's true. Was that your personal ad? Yep, cool. We'll give people a couple more minutes. A little light on them.
Brian, I miss you as host. Your musical styling.
Hey, I'm back. I'm here. I need some good vibes today, you know.
Maybe we should pick a genre for next time before we close this meeting.
I'm fine with that. Drop genre or song recommendations in the chat and I'll queue them up for next time.
I'm thinking some old hair metal ballads.
Some November Rain
or something.
Yeah, look at that. Right, we go to the same place right away.
Yeah, but I was going to the video, not the song.
Oh, yeah, same. Yeah, yeah.
Or maybe some, maybe some Purple Rain. Take a left turn. Little Prince.
Like that too. Like
actually, that too. Might be, I'm going to go with Prince. Yeah, Little Purple Rain.
Yep, love that. All right, we'll give it another minute. All right, everyone. Hey, welcome to our bi-weekly rally creator community call. It's May 5th, so happy May 5th to people who celebrate it. I'm currently in my text messages with my wife and my neighbors. We're talking about whether it's soft tacos tonight or crunchy tacos, so we'll see. I'm not sure. Let's jump right in. Let's see, and I think Joe, you already started recording, so we're on it. All right, let's go. I'll pull that chat up too, so I can keep an eye there. A quick agenda for today. We've got our usual welcome and updates, and then we'll jump into a Solana update, which is really exciting. I know that we've all been looking forward to that, and then wrap it up with some Q&A. As always, we've got our Slido link. You can go to slido.com and use those numbers to get in there, or you can scan that QR code from your mobile device and use that to submit your questions, thoughts, comments, genre nominations for singing for our startup next time, for our starting music. Let's dive right in. So we'll go through some stats updates for me. Quick note on Creator Day at CEX. some release notes from Stephanie, content and education from me, and then developer ecosystem from the one and only Joel. Looking at the Rally sidechain for the last 2 weeks, ending this past Sunday, the first, 86.6 million RLY total value locked in the sidechain, 1 million bridged in, 4.5 million bridged out, 0.6 million in buys versus 0.4 million in converts. And we paid out a total of 4.3 million in RLY rewards. So over $2 million a week for those 2 weeks. Creators, 3 months, still looking good there, up 15% over the last 3 months, adding 40 creators since February. Total RLY in the sidechain up 18%. It's up about 5 million RLY from this time last month. And then wallets, a 22% growth. So an additional just under 2,000 wallets between April and May 1st. And peeking at the leaderboard, I'll let this sit for a second. We can take a look here. Fastest growing, we've got some new movers on there, which is cool. Always good to see a lot of our new athletes really climbing the ranks in terms of growth there. And then total ROI backing, really great list of our biggest tokens there. Stephanie, any call outs on the top 10 lists? Oh, I think you're muted.
I was just saying nothing in particular today, except that everyone is looking really awesome.
Love that. Cool. A fast note of thanks to all of those who were able to make it out for our first ever Creator Day at CEX. This past Monday, we met with about 30 creators in Phoenix, Arizona for a day of stellar content, great conversations. It was so great to meet so many of our creators in real life, including some of you who are on this call, which was great. Great to see so many of our Rally team in one place too. And we hope we can do it again soon. Thanks to all who were able to join. Stephanie, I'll hand it to you for release notes.
Yeah. Hey, everyone. So a couple things. One is TBC V2.2. Man, I'm so excited to not have to say that again really soon. It's out in the wild. So that means that if you're on the V2 token bonding curve, a new vesting schedule dropped on April 15th. Within 10 days, you all should be fully on that new schedule. You will get emails every time you vest. If you are confused about anything, something doesn't make sense, anything seems obviously broken, first check the wiki. I appreciate all the questions I've been getting the past few weeks. We've updated the wiki pretty significantly. We've made a calculator available to everyone. But if you look at that information and you're still unsure, do ask me because it helps us make the documentation better. We've also been making improvements to the Discord bot and created a dedicated Discord bot troubleshooting channel in Discord. So I'm curious if, please feel free to shout out in the comments or on Slido, I forgot the name of the app we use. If you're still not getting what you need out of that, if you have outstanding problems, let us know. I'm really trying to make sure that that bot is working for you all. And then final note, we announced a couple weeks back that we would be issuing new community standards. We shared them on the forum. A couple of people asked questions. We responded. They are now live and effective on the website. If you have not read them, please do. We've significantly updated, particularly in terms of how you can misuse Creator Coin and what flies. That's the biggest change probably as it relates to this group of kind and thoughtful people. So do check that out.
Amazing. Thanks a ton, Stephanie. And folks, feel free to keep Slido questions coming. Joe just dropped the link in the chat. Nice to see some new folks joining the conversation as well this week too. Thanks for being here. A quick note on some fresh content from us. We are still rolling with our great creator interview series. We talked to Dubmatics about educating yourself and your fans on social tokens. I know that's something that we think about a lot is how do we bring our people with us? Happy to drop a link to this content into the chat in just a moment. Rally.io/article is the spot for all the blog content. And as well, we've started launching just some really kind of snackable bite-size case studies on social token launches, social token strategies. So this is the first in a series of stuff that'll be coming on four strategies for a successful social token launch. Should be an interesting read there too. I'll drop it in. And I'll pass it over to Joel for an update on CDC and the dev ecosystem.
Yeah, thanks, Brian. Not a ton of updates on the CDC side. The builders are building. Though we do have a couple of things that have gone live recently. Our coin and NFT polling tool is now live. This essentially allows creators to allow their coin holders to vote on certain issues. It could be cover art for an upcoming album. It could be anything you want. This whole experience is also embeddable into your own website. So a really cool way to have some token-gated voting or polling. No new grants this week. However, one note for those of you who weren't on our dev community call yesterday, we've decided that in an effort to pack that meeting with more info, we're going to reduce the frequency. So that meeting will now live Thursdays at this time, opposite of this meeting. So every other week, bi-weekly, Thursdays, the same time as this meeting. So next week, we will have the dev community call. The following week, we will have this broader community call, and so on and so forth. And you should all have received updated invitations.
Amazing. Thanks a ton, Joel. And with that, I'm going to hand it over to Stephanie, who's going to take us through an update on Rally on Solana.
Okay. All right. So I'm going to take you, there's been a bazillion questions about this. So I'm going to do my best to cover what we have currently pinned down. What you're going to hear from me is honestly not a ton, but probably hopefully better than what you currently know. Definitely questions welcome, but I'm concerned that as you have all noticed, I'm quite chatty, I'm willing to talk, I'm very transparent. Sometimes my words get ahead of what's official and factual. So please do submit your questions to Slido. I will collect them, I will archive them, I will make them part of an FAQ that we're working on as we develop our plans, but I won't be able to speak any to them at all, for the most part, during this call. Okay, next slide. I don't know who has the slide. Okay. All right. So just before I dig in, I did want to sort of remind you that the Solana plans came out of the 22 priorities that Bremner dropped on the forum in January, and then that Chris talked about in his product roadmap at that time as well. So this is, in case you missed it, in case you missed those forum posts, in case you missed Bremner and Chris's product presentations, this is not new. I've heard from a couple people like, whoa, this came out of nowhere. You may have noticed, next slide. You may have noticed that the RLY network has established itself on Solana with the SRLY token. That was a big unlock for us in terms of our ability to build and do explorations. And then there's just a lot of other significant things happening on mainnet and Solana in particular. That means that we are even more excited and more confident in the forthcoming Solana app release. So next slide. So here's what I got for you. So the Solana experience, I do not have a timeline on it yet. We did say it's a 2022 project. It will look a bit different from the Rally.io experience. So as you know, Rally.io, it's built on a side chain. You come to us, you apply for a creator coin. We then mint that coin for you. We have what is called a proof of authority network. We fully manage things like the fiat in and KYC and all the things that make it sort of a safe and secure environment. This will not be that. So what one is that there will be this, essentially this utility layer. We've internally call it Treasure Box. That is not the name of the product. It's just what we call it so that we can not have to explain it every time. So that speaks to a series of on-chain programs that enable anyone to create and launch on the token bonding curve backed by the SRLY token. So we'll basically what we're doing is we're building a UI layer on top of what the RLY Network Association has already built. They're open source programs, they're easy for us to build on top of. And then we'll extend it to other programs. So I'll speak to probably the elephant in the room. I know part of the reason I wanted to give this update today is because Gary has launched on Solana, and this is he did it without TreasureBox. So he basically this thing that Rally.io is building, TreasureBox, is not something that Gary used. He built directly on the RLY Network Association's open source program. And is fully rolling his own. So this was sort of like, he was excited about it, so excited he got ahead and did it himself. We're excited, it's not a bad thing, it's a great thing. He's still building on the RLY network, and it seems to be going well for anyone following along. So for creators, what this means is you will whether it's you or a new creator, anyone, again, instead of coming to Rally, going for an application, us minting your token for you, it'll be self-serve, you'll do it yourself. And then for developers, we're really excited because rather than building on the APIs made available to us via Forte and any infrastructure that we provide or additionally create, you'll be able to interact directly with the TreasureBox SDK. And this means that using the super familiar wallet architecture. Yes, and Jeremiah is saying Gary did not personally do it. Yes, that is true. But I mean like Gary, the company, Gary, G-A-R-Y, Gary Token, not Gary the man. Thank you for that clarification, Jeremiah. But anyway, we're excited because this definitely, from a Web3 architecture point of view, there's a lot of devs building in this space, building on Solana, familiar with building on SDKs, and we think it'll be exciting. We'll have a separate dev weekly meeting to talk more about the SDK when we have more news and more information available on that as well. Okay, that's what I got, folks.
Awesome, thanks, Stephanie. With that, I think I'll pull up the Slido, or Joe, if you have it. Let's see. Check and see if there's any questions there. So it looks like we've got none. Feel free to drop them in, or you can also unmute and ask a question too, if you've got one. We've got quite a bit of time left, and I'm guessing that Solana stuff may have left some questions for folks.
This is KT, not a question, recommending Prince for next week's music.
Thanks, KT. I got you.
Thanks, KT.
Cool. Hey, Chris.
I have a question, if I may.
Yeah, Dave, hop on in.
The question is just a little bit of, I guess, product brand perspective. And I'm a big fan of what we're looking at with Solana, but I'd like to hear a little bit more what the brand's perspective is, like why and what's the opportunity here.
I was saying, pick me. What's up, Dave? How you doing, sir? Good to hear from you. Why Solana? Like many things with the Rally Network Association in particular, these are called shots that have to be called quite a bit in advance. The reason Solana was the network or the chain that the Rally Network Association picked for their first foray into non-Ethereum canonical liquidity. Have I buzzworded you to death yet? But really the reason they're developed on Solana was other components of Superlayer were interested in developing there. Their roadmap in terms of functionality and the robustness of the SPL protocols seemed fairly advanced. Rust was a thing that people felt like they had exposure to or experience with and could easily hire for. This shot was called way before any of Solana's Solana NFT summer led to any of the downtime on any of this. So it was before we knew they had any troubles at all. That said, I'd like to make a small vote in favor of Solana versus Ethereum. Apologies to my colleagues who have heard me beating this drum for the last several days, but you know, over the weekend, Solana had 7 hours of outage, which sucks. Over the weekend also, though, we had the Bored Ape Yacht Club Metaverse drop on Ethereum. And for $300 of or $300 million of value extracted from that Metaverse, $150 million of gas were burned. So it's not the case that you know, it's not great that Solana had outage, but when Solana gets inundated, it tends to stop transactions. When Ethereum gets inundated, it makes transactions so prohibitively expensive that you may as well stop, but you can also get caught in a crossfire with just absolutely ludicrous gas fees. So it's not like there's a perfect answer back and forth, but I would say we're still bullish Solana. It's not the last chain we're ever going to migrate to or have exposure to. And because the Rally Network Association got us liquidity there, that's what made it a good fit for us. And they made that decision about a year ago.
Thank you, sir. I just wanted to hear the kind of officially statement, and totally. You nailed it. Thank you.
I think definitely questions like that, fair game. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to like shut it down. I mean, like any questions about more detail on Rally's plans for Solana, we just don't have answers at this time than what I gave.
You got lots of hopes, lots of dreams, some wishes, and occasional whispered nothings.
Though, Chris, along these lines, Richard had a comment in the chat. I wanted to call out for you. I thought maybe you could speak to. Oh my God, Mark, yes.
Sorry, everything is weird with my left hand and it takes me 10 minutes to do things.
Not a question since it's so early, but a note that it's really important to get the APIs being able to access Treasure Box as well.
Yeah.
Otherwise, anything currently built using APIs will have to be rebuilt.
It is a fantastic call out, Richard. So we are about to be able to share documentation on the Treasure Box SDK. Treasurebox is an SDK and not an API-based system. So that means integration. The perspective of our folks, and you guys know like Alexander and the other guys that had worked on Discord bot and things like that. Those guys are the ones standing up Treasurebox. So their perspective was that it might not be the easiest integration path to try to just tie the existing API into that SDK versus working with individuals like yourself to integrate the SDK into what you're doing. I would say be loud, have an opinion on this and talk to us. Why don't we, like the SDK documentation is really, really minimal at present. It's really straightforward. But basically, like, let's have a conversation about this. If there are things that we can build to make your life better, we can and will build those things. But if we could also just assist you in directly integrating the SDK into your projects, particularly given that that makes you compatible with anything on Solana, that might be a good answer for your project, and we can find ways to help. So no one answer to this. Let's figure it out together, I think is my conclusion right now. Until we get more data.
And Chris, something we've talked about a lot, you know, and part of why approaching a mainnet is so exciting is all of the existing utility that sits out there. And so, you know, the ability to once we're there, there's a lot being built on Solana. There's a lot that's live. There's a lot more coming. And I think it's really interesting to think about how we as Rally can then help accelerate development that fills the needs of our creators and of their communities too.
Exactly. Like for the stuff that we're building for the API, it can't really go outside of the bounds of the sidechain, but integrating with SDKs that can talk to Solana means that any creator doing stuff on Solana is an advertising platform for your new product, right? And that can apply to any other project on Solana. So
I'll just also chime in, I guess, from the conversations with the major platforms. I think if we think about the Twitters of the world or the TikToks of the world, or you know, the places where our creators already interact with their communities, being on a mainnet experience is going to looking, as they all make their first foray into blockchain, they're looking to enable as many use cases as possible with as little work as possible. And so integrating standalone side chains is really not feasible for them. So I think just adding to what Chris mentioned and Brian mentioned in terms of the developer network that's there and that is already building for Solana, I think it also kind of can help further what we might be able to do in the future with platforms.
Awesome. I also wanted to shout out the question about, is there a recap about Creator Day, some sort of video? Nope, got to be there, got to come, join us next time. what happens in Phoenix stays in Phoenix. But no, we actually love the programming and love the content, and definitely will bring some of it online to future of these community calls for sure. And then I did also want to say to all the devs in the call, we can continue the Solana conversation next week too in the dev meeting.
So, thanks, Stephanie, if you don't mind, for next week's dev call, if any of the community devs have burning questions wrapped around the Solana, and you want to write them down before you forget them, you can go ahead and send them over to me, and I'll make sure that we have those available for next week. And the sooner I get them, the sooner I can send them off to see if we can actually get some information before the call.
And we'll invite the Icarus team to join so that you get actual technical answers as opposed to telephone games of technical answers through me.
That's great, Chris. Thank you. Yes, the group photo's on Twitter. And right, Brian?
It's on Twitter. It was also in the weekly digest as well. The weekly digest email that went out to the community.
I'm sorry, I don't visit Web2 platforms.
Like email or like Twitter? No, you're muted, it's fine. Okay, everyone.
Slido.
Let's see. Oh, thanks, Jared. I'll be over to Slido in just a moment.
So Jared, I'll take this one. So I posted recently in the Discord about this. We've done the math inside, outside, upside down, sideways in conversation with creators, had many furrowed brow conversations about it. And it does not look like switching from V1 to V2 is possible. It just doesn't work. It's like from a rally backing point of view. And I'm sorry for that. But I did, I think Jared, you're in Discord, right? So if you go to Discord, I did share some other like thoughts between, thinking about how we handle rewards or even thinking about Solana. There's a couple other ways to think about the future of your token that doesn't include migration. Someone asked about, it says, I see a lot of work of Superlayer on Solana. Is there going to be an opportunity to collab with other Superlayer apps and Rally.io once creator coins on Sol are Sol native?
Interoperability! I mean, yeah, that's the win, right? That's the win state. Because it's clear that Superlayer projects were not going to be easily interoperable with the sidechain. Now we have both a common token as well as a common programming language, and then sky's the limit on that.
Jared, I think if you wanted to shut your token down, I don't know how many holders you have, but if you could, that you could absolutely, if you want to figure out a way to engineer a way to shut your token down that wouldn't leave people like in a terrible lurch, definitely welcome to do that. We would be happy to launch a new token with you. But I will say, we've definitely talked to other creators about this idea, and with the amount of holders they had, with what was in their respective wallets, it just felt like very expensive to do to keep people whole. But if you can figure out a way, or again, I don't know what your specifics of your token are, but if you could figure it out, we're here to support. we're not trying to be gatekeepers on this one, I guess is like the TLDR of my headline here. It is marvelously difficult. That's a great way to describe it.
Jared, if it was easy, everyone would be doing it.
Yeah. Anyone who is at Creator Day who wants to updated vesting has kicked in. It kicked in on April 15th. If your token, however, launched, if your like anniversary date was between April 1st and April 14th, you still would not have vested yet on the new schedule. You will vest by your upcoming May anniversary date. Check out the wiki. I think I dropped the link in the chat. I can redrop it for the details on that. I was gonna say for anyone who is at Creator Day, if you wanted to unmute or cam on and share, because do the recap. We'd love to hear from you about what was great about it or what you hated about it. Hate is always welcome. No.
Hey guys, this is Puyan from Scary Kids. We run the Scary Coin, which is ultimately a fan club for our fan base. So really enjoyed Creator Day. I thought it was a great opportunity to not only meet y'all in person, but get to ask just general questions about the platform and the goals and learn more about the community. I think ultimately my biggest takeaway was some strategy for rollouts that we want to do for NFTs, how to add value to our community, and to speak candidly about some of the challenges that we were having with other folks, even though, some of those folks were really cross-discipline and were trying to achieve different things and had different strategies for their coin. Some of their approaches were consistently valuable to us. And just being able to kind of chat, have a couple beers, shoot the shit, and just be super open about that stuff was really great and helpful. And I hope you have more of them.
Awesome. Thank you, Puyan. And we did record, sort of do some Q&As with some attendees. I think you included, right?
Yeah, that's right. Yeah.
Yeah, so folks, you can look forward to that exciting content to drop as well. Anyone else? I know I'm not going to call anyone out, but I know I know some of you were there. If you want to share. No pressure. Cool. If you haven't done your survey, do your survey. Let us know what you thought. I know Brian already said it. I'll say it again for any latecomers. We'd love to hear from you. There was also a big request to share email addresses for attendees. So that's the place where you can opt in to share your email address in chat. Continue the conversation. And we will do more for sure.
Cool. Well, with that, we'll call it a wrap for the day. Thanks a ton to everyone who was able to join today. Look for a recording of this if you missed some of it. I think we had some latecomers. I'll drop that in the Discord by the end of the week. Thanks again, Stephanie. Thanks for the update on Solana stuff. And thanks to everyone for being here. Catch you later.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Beautiful, a lot of time.